Alamance County is pleased to present the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting.
You read?
Yeah.
David.
Bring him in.
It was Saturday night, the sun shone anyway.
Did you really? Appreciate you. You already will.
Let it roll.
Who has the bill?
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Alamance County Board of Commissioners is now in session. Call on Vice Chairman Lashley to lead us in invocation to be followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.
Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you at this time thanking you for this day, thanking you for the life that you give us. We thank you for the everyday conveniences that we have in this great country of ours. We ask you to bless this day, bless this county, and in your holy name we pray. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The first item of business is to approve the minutes of the last meeting. Is there a motion to approve that agenda?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Oh, yeah. Recognition of our outgoing commissioners. If I may... Or you help a little bit here. Let's move around a little bit. John Paisley. John, the county would like to present you this for your good service over the last, 10 months?
Yes, sir.
It's been a pleasure for me to work with you. It really has been. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. And best of luck to you, John.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate
it. Mr. William Lashley. Bill, on behalf of Alamance County, we would like to present you with this flag for the 18 years of service that you've given Alamance County.
It's been a pleasure.
I've worked for you and served with you, enjoyed every minute of it, and best of luck to you and your family.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next item of business is to administer oath of office for the new county commissioners. Judge Robinson, you want to come up, please, sir? I understand you're going to do honors.
I am.
Your honor?
My honor.
Your honor. Again, I would like to take privilege of this office and change the way of calling just a little bit and call on Mr. Dan Engel to be sworn in. Dan, if you want to come forward, your family, anybody you want to bring with you.
For my mother, I don't see her. I don't know what she got here. You
got on the Bible?
Yes, sir. Good morning, Judge.
If you'll repeat after me, please. I, Dan W. Engel.
I, Dan W. Engel.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support and maintain.
That I will support and maintain.
The Constitution and laws.
The Constitution and laws.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws.
And the Constitution and laws.
Of North Carolina.
Of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Discharge the duties.
Discharge the duties
of my office.
Of my office.
As county commissioner.
As county commissioner.
For the county of Alamance.
For the county of Alamance.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, Dan W. Engel.
I, Dan W. Engel.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will well.
That I will well.
And truly execute.
And truly execute.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of County Commissioner.
Of County Commissioner.
For the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
According to the best.
According to the best.
Of my skill and ability.
Of my skill and ability.
According to law.
According to law.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Commissioner.
Thank you, Judge. Appreciate it.
Dan, you would take your seat, please.
Would you like to sit next to me?
Before you do that, Dan, we're going to make this official, Judge Smith, and you'll sign right there.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Dan. Congratulations.
Mr. Boswell, Mr. Eddie Boswell. Eddie, you have family here?
I do, my wife Gail.
Hi, Gail, if you'll hold the Bible for Eddie, please. Eddie, put your left hand on the Bible, raise your right hand. And repeat after me. I, Eddie D. Boswell.
I, Eddie D. Boswell.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
And maintain.
And maintain.
The Constitution and laws.
The Constitution and laws.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws.
And the Constitution and laws.
Of North Carolina.
Of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Discharge the duties.
Discharge the duties.
Of my office.
Of my office.
As County Commissioner.
As County Commissioner.
For the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, Eddie D. Boswell.
I, Eddie D. Boswell.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will well.
That I will well.
And truly.
And truly.
Execute the duties.
Execute the duties.
Of the office.
Of the office.
Of County Commissioner.
County Commissioner.
For the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
According to the best.
According to the best.
Of my skill and ability.
Of my skill and ability.
According to law.
According to law.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Commissioner.
Now the real newest commissioner, Mr. Robert Byrd, Bob.
Good to see you.
My wife Barbara.
Barbara, if you hold the Bible, we met each other many times. You'll repeat after me. I, Robert E. Byrd.
I, Robert E. Byrd.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
And maintain.
And maintain.
The Constitution and laws.
The Constitution and laws.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws.
And the Constitution and laws.
Of North Carolina.
Of North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Discharge the duties.
Discharge the duties.
Of my office.
Of my office.
As County Commissioner.
As County Commissioner.
For the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, Robert E. Byrd.
I, Robert E. Byrd.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will well.
That I will well.
And truly.
And truly.
Execute the duties.
Execute the duties.
Of the office of County Commissioner.
Of the office of County Commissioner.
For the County of Alamance.
For the County of Alamance.
According to the best.
According to the best.
Of my skill and ability.
Of my skill and ability.
According to law.
According to law.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Commissioner.
Thank you.
Let's get you officially signed up.
Go ahead and do that. To move things along, we're going ahead and swear in the oath of, with give oath of office to the Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisors, Justin McPherson, Fred Bowman, Harold Rainey. Judge Robertson?
Thank you. If y'all will come up here as a group, please. There's enough in this Bible for people to share.
If you'll repeat after me, please. I, and then state your name.
I, Tyler McPherson.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
And maintain.
And maintain.
The Constitution and laws.
The Constitution and laws.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the Constitution and laws.
The Constitution and laws.
Of North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Not inconsistent therewith.
Not inconsistent therewith.
And that I will faithfully.
And that I will faithfully.
Discharge the duties.
Discharge the duties.
Of my office.
Of my office.
As Alamance Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisor.
Alamance Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisor.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, and then state your name.
I, Harold McPherson.
Do solemnly.
Do solemnly.
And sincerely swear.
And sincerely swear.
That I will support.
That I will support.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
That I will be faithful.
That I will be faithful.
And bear true allegiance.
Bear true allegiance.
To the state of North Carolina.
To the state of North Carolina.
And to the constitutional powers.
And to the constitutional powers.
And authorities. Which are.
Which are.
Or may be.
Or may be.
Established.
Established.
For the government thereof.
For the government thereof.
And that I will endeavor.
That I will endeavor.
To support.
To support.
Maintain and defend.
Maintain and defend.
The Constitution of said state.
The Constitution of said state.
Not inconsistent with.
Not inconsistent with.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
To the best of my knowledge.
To the best of my knowledge.
And ability.
And ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
I, and then state your name.
I, Harold McPherson.
Do swear.
Do swear.
That I will well.
That I will well.
And truly.
And truly.
Execute the duties.
Execute the duties.
Of my office.
Of my office.
As Alamance Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisor.
Alamance Soil and Water Conservation District Supervisor.
According to the best.
According to the best.
Of my skill and ability.
My skill and ability.
According to law.
According to law.
So help me God.
So help me God. Amen.
Amen. Let's get y'all signed up here. Maybe do this one second.
Sure.
Fred, you'll sign right there.
You might.
Thank you. Thank you. Justin, if you'll sign it here for me. Oh, right here. Thank you. Can I have a point of personal privilege here?
Go right ahead, John.
Commissioners and those who have also served, this is my last opportunity to speak to you as the Chief District Court Judge for Alamance. And I'm very honored by the relationship we've had over the years. And we've done some good things. Our group, this group, this administration, and the courts, the district courts in particular is the one I'm most focusing on. And I think we ought to be proud of that. But it wouldn't have happened but for that relationship and the good folks that have served on the Board of County Commissioners. And for that, I want to deeply, deeply thank you all. And I look forward to that type of relationship continuing with the new Chief District Court Judge. So from all of us on the district, in the district court family, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Honor. Thank you for your service, Judge. And continued service. Mr. Manager, if you would come forward and...
Hey, if I can do it from here, if you
be
don't
fine.
Mind. Thank you, Mr. Chair. This time we do need to do the election for the chairman of the Board of Commissioners, and the floor is open for nominations.
I would like to nominate Dan Engel to be chairman.
And I'd like to second that nomination.
There's a nomination and second. Any other nominations or any discussion on that? We'll put this up for a vote. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Nomination approved. Chairman
Engel. Thank you. First thing I'd like to do is thank Commissioner Smith for his outstanding service as the chair for the past about a year now, Judge. Thank you for that. Really appreciate that. And with that being said, we have now, we need to elect the vice chairman, and I will accept nominations for the vice chairman. I would like to go ahead as the chairman and pose a nomination myself, and I'd like to nominate Eddie Boswell as vice chair. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Thank you. Thank you, Judge. Any other nominations? Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you. Eddie, thank you, congratulations. Next on the agenda, item number two is we have a public hearing on economic development, Southern Seasons Corporation. I'd like to welcome Mike Williams. Mike.
Good morning, Commissioners, and congratulations to you folks who are newly seated and appointed. Look forward to working with you in the coming years. We are starting out this morning with a public hearing for a company called Southern Seasons. We have a gentleman here representing the company who will be happy to speak to you and to answer the questions that you and the public may have about this proposal. The company represented today is Brian Falver. He is the CFO for Southern Seasons, and I'll ask Brian to come up to the podium now, and he can speak a little bit about what the project is about, the company itself, and answer any questions you may have. Brian?
Thank you.
Good morning, Commissioners. So Southern Seasons has been around since 1975. I hope if you hadn't had a chance to visit our store in Chapel Hill, I hope you'll visit around this time of year because it's a great place to get gifts. We have over 80,000 items in our store. We're really focused on specialty food and gourmet products and educating folks about them and giving folks access to products from all over the world, but many of which are from North Carolina. A lot of local artisans are represented on our shelves. And to manage 80,000 items, you got to have a distribution center that's efficient and can help us buy, in many cases, small amounts from what we can call very small businesses that only operate in small batches. And we provide a great service for them by being able to take those into a distribution center and get those products pushed out to our stores. We currently have a distribution center in Hillsboro, And we're looking, we've outgrown this distribution center with the growth of the company and are looking to let other options for our DC and hope we can do it here in Alamance County. 100,000-foot building, probably have about 45 full-time equivalent jobs in the distribution center. And Southern Season is on a growth path where we are looking at options for sites all across the southeast. And my goal and our goal is to bring more stores to the Mid-Atlantic and the South. And so having a distribution center in this area would really help that effort. So with that, I'll answer any questions you have.
Bring it on.
thank you, Brian. Any questions from our commissioners?
Brian, I did go on your website and look now. Do you have four other stores that you're involved in or distribution centers or something?
So we've got three stores now.
Okay.
Richmond and Charleston, and then our flagship location is down the street in Chapel Hill.
Oh, okay.
And we have two, we have technically five. We've got two seasonal pop-up stores.
I went on the website and look.
Those are in Raleigh and Charlotte.
Right.
But they'll shut down in January.
Would this proposed center replace the one in Hillsboro or be in addition to?
It would. Yeah, it would be a replacement.
And you can't expand in Orange County?
We can't. We can't expand. This is the building that we're in has been around for a long time, and it's actually in a regular shape, so it's becoming inefficient for us to operate there.
We're at in Hillsboro.
So it's on Eno Street.
Eno Street.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm on the Piedmont Food and Ag Processing mm-hmm. Board there in Hillsboro, and of course they make a lot of local products, and I'm hoping that maybe your store, I can go in there and see something today.
Yeah, so
I'm making a pitch for them while we're at it.
No, you know, so that's our business. We specialize in carrying products that are from groups just like that, because larger chains that are focused on distribution and more widely available products, you know, they typically pass by. But we actually get up every day figuring out ways to get those products on our shelves.
We'd love to have you come visit our facility there, which the county was actually a part in establishing.
That'd be great.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you. Any other questions for Brian?
I had just one more. The 45 full-time equivalent employees, are those going to be transferred, or are they be likely new employees as a result of the expansion?
Most of the senior leadership, I would hope that we will be able to get to transfer. I can't speak for everyone, but it remains to be seen. We do think that we'll have a really solid employment base to work from here, perhaps better than in Hillsboro. So that's part of the thinking in locating here.
Is there an average pay that you're projecting on those?
It's $15 an hour.
$15 an hour.
Any further questions? Thank you, Brian. Ms. Hackett, I wonder if you would just run the numbers before the board.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Be glad to. They've changed a little bit than what's in your agreement up front. We're also trying to work out what Mebane, they're also going to Mebane today and looking at a similar incentive agreement. The number has changed from $5,923,000. It was $6.3 million. Mebane may be using $6 million. So there's not a lot of a dollar change that would be, but I would, you know, whatever the agreement is maybe we wait for the final number until we get their final evaluation, what Mebane is planning to do, because right now they're saying that they're only going up to a max of $6 million as far as investment. If they do go up to $6 million on investment, our incentive would be based upon that. That would be $90,000 over a five-year period, which would be $18,000 a year annually. The taxes on that would be $31,800, and that means we would be to the good $13,800 for the first 5 years, and then, you know, everything after that would be $31,800 to the good after 5 years. But if the board is approving of this agreement, it allows staff to finalize the numbers with Mebane. It won't change our distribution, maybe a couple $1,000 one way or the other, but wait for what Mebane finally does approve today.
And you do have other options you say you're looking at?
We are looking around. Most of our searches in North and South Carolina, just based on the near-term growth of southern season and where our stores are currently located, we need to be in the mid-Atlantic or southeastern United States.
It'd be nice to keep you here.
Yeah, it would.
Yes, it would. Any further questions? This is a public hearing, so at this time I will open the floor to any of the general public. Thank you, Brian.
Thank you.
If they'd like to make any comments to the board at this time, I'm going to start over here with the first row. Anybody on the first row? Second row? Yes, sir. Come up. Identify yourself, if you would, sir. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, Commissioners.
Good morning.
Mr. Lamar. My name is Robert Lamar. I am a resident here of Alamance County, and just so y'all know, I am current on my taxes. So we're good. Seriously, I'm here on behalf of Solis Plantation for Kids. It's a new center here focusing on an old concept, and that's caring for children. Our design for kids will be a place for comfort and healing for the kids and the families being treated.
Mr. Lamar, sir, this is a public hearing for
on the incentive.
On the incentive agreement, sir.
Well, I'm sorry.
Well, that's okay. No, that's not a problem.
We will certainly get to speak.
Oh, yes,
sure.
Yes.
Thank
That'd
you,
be
sir.
Public
Thank
comments,
you.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is a public hearing for this economic incentive. Any folks on the back row or on the second or the back row on this side like to speak? All right, moving over here. First row, second row, anyone? First row, second row, third row, fourth row, in the back. All right, there were no further comments. This closes the public hearing, and at this time I'll ask if there's a motion. If any member of the board would like to entertain a motion.
I'll second that, Chair.
Right. Motion and second.
Mr. Chairman, if I could get the clarification, is that the final valuation will be based upon what Mebane does. It will not change our figures that drastically, but their valuation is looking at 6.3. Mebane has put a max at 6 million, and I didn't want to do any more or any less than what Mebane did.
So be contingent on the motion for this entertaining, that we entertain, be contingent on what the city of Mebane
does on
terms of valuation. I have a motion and a second. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Motion carries. All right, moving on. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Williams. Thank you. Moving on to Mr. Albright, bid report and acceptance of bid for property at 1212 Turrentine Street.
Morning.
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 The prior board approved advertisement for bids for the property at Turrentine Street, currently occupied by Ralph Scott Homes. Ralph Scott was the only one that bid on the property. We got their check for $1,000. And so I'm come before you this morning asking you to consider the approval of the sale of the property to Ralph Scott Homes for $1,000. And I will remind the board that a consideration can also include the type of services they provide to the community, and they do a lot of good work. And this will put the property in their hands and allow them to borrow money and improve it, which they have not been able to do since the county owned it. So I'm asking for a motion to approve the sale. We're going to have to wait until the city of Burlington approves the division of the property at their planning board meeting. And then after they approve it, then we can go ahead and tender a deed to them.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Albright. Any questions, yes, Mr. Albright? Do I hear a motion to approve the sale?
I'll make a motion that we approve it.
And I'll second the motion.
Motion is second. Those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Opposed, no. The ayes carry. Thank you, Mr. Albright.
Thank
we have
you,
a second item here.
Yes, sir.
This sale of disposition of county property. Mr. Albright.
This is another piece of property the county's owned for about 40 years and currently occupied by Residential Treatment Services of Alamance. They provide a benefits to the community by treating people. I think you may have this brochure on your packet, Treating People with Addictions, Alcoholism and Drugs and Mental Illness. Provide a very good service to the county, and I would propose that we enter into the same procedure we did with the Tarrantine property to advertise the property for a sealed bid under 143-129. We'll advertise it in the paper, and we'll take sealed bids, and then I'll come before you in 30 days plus with the results of those bids. And then we can, if the board approves, transfer this property to this organization, and they'll be able to borrow money and maintain it. The county just has not maintained these properties like we should have.
So right now you're asking for motion approval of the resolution?
To advertise the sealed bids like we did with the Tarrantine Street property for Ralph Scott Homes. We'll put an advertisement in the newspaper advising people that the property is going to be sold by sealed bid. We'll give them 30 days to send their bids in. If any other bids do come in, we of course will bring that to the board, and ultimately it's the board's decision to decide to transfer the property.
Thanks, sir. Any questions?
I just want to make a comment. I think we have a whole row of the board members on the back here from residential treatment, Ron Osborne being the executive officer for him, and having been involved in some of their fundraisers and heard the results of their clients. It is a wonderful organization, and I just commend them for what they do and for helping our county out.
Thank you, Commissioner. All right, you've heard the Mr. Albright. Does anybody have a motion?
I'd like to move that we accept Mr. Albright's recommendation to move forward with the advertising as you described.
Yes, and I'll second that one.
Motion and second. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you, Mr. Albright.
Thank you. We'll run the ad in this Thursday's paper, and 30 days from that date, we'll close the bid, and I'll report to the board.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Mr. Honeycutt, review of the bonds of public officials.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Attached in your agenda packet is a resolution for the review of public officials' bonds. This is basically to meet our statutory requirements. We do this on an annual basis.
Right. I had one question on that, Mr. Chair.
Yes, sir.
Why is Susan on there twice? Is she special?
I had that question, too.
If you want to
ask that question.
Susan's on there.
Susan is special, but there is other reasons as well.
Yeah, there is a reason, Commissioner Boswell. The first $100,000 is for the county, then the additional $50,000 is for my position with the Alamance County Tourism Development Authority. I have to be bonded in both places.
So you're bonded wherever you go, pretty much.
These are indemnity bonds.
Yes.
Okay. So if she does get sued and the bond company pays, then they'll turn around and ask the county to pay.
Right.
Yes. But this is no more, no less what the general statutes require.
Okay. Very good. That was just caught my eye when I saw her name twice.
All right. So we need board approval, don't we?
Yes, sir.
All right. Any questions for Mr. Honeycutt? Do I hear a motion that we approve the bonds as set by staff?
I'll make a motion that we approve that, Mr. Chair.
A second?
I'll second.
Second, Linda. All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Thank you. All right, last item to discuss before we get to public speakers, a discussion of the longevity for county employees. And this was placed on the agenda by me. I've had discussions with others. Back 2 years ago, it's been about 2 years ago, when the longevity was taken from the county employees, there was a 55% gap in terms of them their money being placed back somewhere in their pay, etc. 45% that was taken the following fiscal year was placed back with employees by way of a raise. In other words, it was made a part of their salary. With that being said, there was still a 55% that was never placed back in to the employees. Now, when you think about that and you think about the fact that we are competing with other agencies, like it or not, to keep the best qualified staff that we can keep here in this county, whether it be municipalities or other counties that are adjacent to us, there are things that we as a county need to do to make sure that we keep the best employees that we can. And when that cut was made, it really didn't hurt those that had 5 years or 6 years as much as it did staff that had been with us loyally. When you look at employee benefits, they've been with us loyally for years and years, 10 years, 15 years. So it was certainly a cut. Now, with that being said, this is something, if you look at it as a service oriented, which is what it is, for the years of service that that employee gives, you know, one thing that maybe this board could look at down the road is that we do it on their anniversary date, if it's a problem with the time of year. That's something certainly we could discuss at that time. But I'm open to this board as to whether you would like to. First of all, I'll ask for comments from this board on what I just said. Any of you, I'll open the floor to comments.
Well, I have a comment. About a year and a half ago, the commissioners gave a 5% raise to all employees. And then I think the next year voted to do away with half of the longevity, and then this year's budget, it was all of it. So in the last 2 years, employees have received a 5% raise. Then they lost, depending on how much you were getting in longevity, 2 to 6%. They lost half of it. They lost all of it, really. And then this year we gave back almost half of it in the budget. I have no objections to the board approving that the remaining 50 or 55%, whatever it is, be reinstated to the employees as their regular pay. But I think it needs to be done in the new budget. This board needs to know, if they do not know, that we have $3.5 million of fund balance budgeted in this year's budget, and it's going to be extremely hard to not dip into the fund balance this year. So it took us 2 years, I know, at least, to build the fund balance back to where the state of North Carolina, the Department of the Treasury, was threatening to take over and run for us if we didn't get our fund balance over, the undesignated fund balance, over 8%. And we did, and it's in pretty good shape now. But budgeting $3.5 million for this year is really a precarious situation for the county to be in. And we need to be very careful, and we don't need to go spending right off the bat here to try to, I don't know, it sounds kind of like a political payback to me, but I do think the intent is well taken. I do agree with it, but it needs to be in the budget that we should start working on pretty soon.
Well, can I?
Yes, sir.
A couple of things. When that decision was made, and I was watching the decision, it seemed like the taking away of the longevity bonus was done kind of at the spur of the moment. It was a spur of the moment decision that really wasn't deliberated on, and I was kind of concerned that it wasn't done in the context of the overall wage and salary program. I firmly believe that we need to have a competitive wage and salary program for our county employees, so that we can attract and retain the very best, and a program that in effect treats people with dignity and respect. So I'm not opposed at all by reinstating this bonus, but I would like to think about doing that in terms of, as we move forward, let's take another look. I understand that there's a wage and salary program and an analysis going on right now, and seeing how competitive we really are. And I think that's what we need to, how we need to approach it moving forward after we get past reinstating when that was, in my opinion, kind of unfairly taken away.
Thank you. Any other comments, commissioners?
Well, I didn't vote for it when it went out. I'm going to tell you right now.
Thank you, Commissioner Massey. I'd like to ask the the county manager the approximate cost?
I think approximate cost is about $600,000.
$600,000?
Yes, sir.
And that's based on budgeted as of July 1?
Right. That's July 1's budget numbers. You know, we can give you a better breakdown of who gets what at our next meeting and do that. And I know there has been the discussion, but we'll be glad to do whatever the board so chooses.
Well, if I can make a comment, I feel like Dan and Bob both, that it got done somewhat impulsively last year when it was taken away. And I do recognize that a lot of employees that have dedicated their life to this county and working for this county ended up on the short end of the raise, let's put it that way, because of their longevity outweighed the raise they got. And they made a lot of life decisions in those 15, 20 years they've been here. And in those decisions, they weighed in that into their wages, because if they went elsewhere looking at wages, they had that as part of that, I'm sure. I mean, anybody with a normal sense of money would say, oh, I'm going to get a longevity, and they figured that into their salary before they made a decision to jump ship, go to Guilford County, Orange County, or other counties that are paying more than we are locally. Right now, I agree with Bob that we do need to do a longevity or pay wage and salary study for the county. I would like to see us possibly move on this before the end of the year, because last year, I know there, and going around the county as we were campaigning, there were a lot of dissatisfied employees in our county, and a lot of it was based around this one thing. They come to me, some of them, and said, you know, last year we didn't get a Christmas because that's what we had counted on, and it just got yanked away from us, and we didn't have a chance to adjust. And I just felt that was wrong. Do we need to make an action today? My personal opinion, let Craig and him run the numbers. Let's look at it. Let's come up with an actual proposal would be my thought on that.
Thank you. Any other comments? Mr. County Manager, what I would like, and with the board's blessing, is for you to run the numbers, determine exactly what it's going to cost us. Also implementing this, making this a part of the pay plan study to coincide with the pay plan study that is being done at this time for the future. And with the agreement with the board here that we will vote on this matter at the next meeting. And I think that's pretty much the consensus of the board.
I will agree.
Any further questions?
I agree with that. That's great.
All right, moving on, we have public speakers, and I'm going to call on going right down the list. First is Mr. Tony Cox.
First off, congratulations to all of you commissioners.
Thank you.
Mr. Bird just made a comment. Been a lot of flying by the seat of the britches down here at these county commissioners, and it's created some issues for the people and staff of this county. We need good, solid, sound decisions. A lot of times there's been chasing of things. And you know, in the money thing, the people that jumped up and took off, in some of them cases, maybe it was a good thing. Okay. I come to these county commissioners meetings, and everybody knows it, because of a situation in 2007. The adoption of ordinances, again, flying by the seat of the britches. About 6 weeks ago or so, I was informed that the High Impact Land Use and Polluting Industries Ordinance is still at play. And I think through the special subcommittees and board meetings and so forth, a lot of stuff come out about those, again, flying by the seat of the britches. And I was under the impression that that ordinance is gone. It was rescinded with the admission of wrongdoing, both in the adoption and the enforcement of the ordinance. And I would like to hear some comments on that today. I'm just like everybody else. I want to see this county do good. Hey, I worked my butt off to do better. Believe that. And I want to help this county. And so, we the people need help too. We need good, solid, sound decisions from you five. We need good leadership. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Scott. All right, Robert Lamar. Mr. Lamar.
That's good.
So it's part of my abomination.
That's
of the
okay, Mr. Lamar.
That's all right.
Again, my name is Robert Lamar. I'm just going to, I've got a paper, but I'm just going to tell it like it is. I'm here to talk about and to introduce myself and our dream and mission. It's a faith-based mission of Solace Plantation for Kids. It's a family-centered facility, nonprofit, faith-based, mission-oriented. Our focal points will be the cornerstone of our success. Those cornerstones will be providing for the families in our local hospitals or at our local hospitals that are discharged in limbo between treatments, if that kind of spells it out. We are setting up to provide housing, meals, and therapeutic services. The structured therapy will be physical, occupational, equine, aquatic, and psychological. So all these kind of blend together. If you've been around these, the horse therapy group over here, and they're great, and it's great for the kids. The recreational therapies will be hiking, fishing, kayaking, archery, and crafts, and others according to the needs and wants of the families. The main one, I'm not going to say the main, but the one of the top two concentrations is for whole family wellness, not just the kids that are being treated for these debilitating diseases, but also for the siblings that kind of somehow may get swept under the rug sometimes with all the attention. So if we could build a sense of community within their families and support from other families and our trained therapists, it'll build a whole family, making the family whole one individual at a time as a whole group. That's what our focuses are going to be. The location that we're hoping to get, and if y'all have any input or any way that we could that could help us, we're wanting to purchase Quarter Hills Golf Course. I have a personal reason for wanting that course. I broke my back 2 years ago. I ended up out there working, and it has all come together. God pushed this plan in my lap, and I didn't want it to start with, but I don't have a choice now. It's rolling, and it is going to roll.
Go ahead, finish your sentence.
I come to you as a representative of Solace Plantation for Kids in hopes that you, our commissioners, and other county representatives in attendance today get excited about this opportunity. This property will be a catalyst for Alamance County to become a sanctuary of healing. With God, with the good Lord guiding the way and good folks wrapping their hearts and minds and faith around this, it'll be a fantastic addition to this county. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lamar. Yes. Appreciate it. All right, it's time for remarks from our newly elected officials. Mr. Bird, I'll start with you.
All right. Well, I want to thank everybody for their vote of confidence in voting for me in this last election. This is an experience that's, of course, very humbling, and I'm going to take it very seriously. and work very hard for everybody and with everybody, and do what's best to make Alamance County better and better. When I was getting ready to retire from Alamance Regional, and it was imminent, my wife asked me, "So what are you going to do?" And her advice was, whatever it is, you need to do something where you can utilize your lifetime of experiences and leadership in Alamance County and put those to good use. So I decided that I would run for this office. And then my wife, and this is my wife Barbara here, by the way, she's my my soulmate and my inspiration, but she said that just remember, you're running and not me. But she was going to support me, and in fact she has, and my timid wife is can work a crowd like you wouldn't believe when during a campaign, so but I'm so pleased that she's here today, and I look forward to serving everybody. Thank you.
Thank you. Judge?
I don't know. No? Just welcome all three of you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Judge. Thank
appreciate
you.
It. Forward to working with you.
Thank you, Judge.
Oh, I've been here a long time, so, you know. But I'm glad to have you again. I worked with Eddie. I worked with Dan. So glad to have you, Bob.
Thank you.
Glad to have Mr. Smith.
Well, I would like to say a few things. First off, I come here very happy today and sad. This weekend, one of my good friends, mentor, and mother-in-law, she died. And it's just a sad day, but I do look forward to working for the county, and I'm going to just tell her up in heaven, because that's where she headed off to Saturday. I'm up here today because she prayed. A lot of people prayed. And I just hope I can do a good job.
We all
have. Gail, certainly our condolences to you, Gail, to the family. Well, I said 2 years ago, well, first of all, let me say, my wife back in 2004, I hadn't told this story to many, but very brief, the day before the filing deadline for county commissioner, I went and told my wife I was thinking about running for county commissioner, and she said, whatever, you know, she just kind of said, well, it's just another one of them ideas Dan's got. And So 30 minutes before the filing deadline, I went and filed for county commissioner. We were eating supper that night, and I said, well, honey, I did it. She said, what'd you do? I said, I filed for county commissioner today. And she said, have you lost your mind? But serving that 4.5 years from 05 to middle 09 was some of the most rewarding years of my life, and serving with the men that I did, Bill Lashley. Bill, thank you for your service. Bill was always there, just a fine man. Tim Sutton, another fine man. Larry Sharp, Linda, that I served with, Eddie, that I served with, all good people. And I could just go on, every single one of them. We had an outstanding county manager, county attorney and manager in David Smith. Thank you. Thank you, Judge, for the outstanding job that you did. And this county, continue on with the work for the people. And we, this board now, when I look at this board.
He's got a phone.
Okay.
They won't talk.
If I was smart, I'd turn it off.
A smartphone just makes a fool out of me.
Thank you, Senator Webster. When I look at this board now, I see some great things on the horizon with this board. Bob, Eddie, Linda, Judge, and I'm excited about it. We have a great staff, Ms. Honeycutt and your staff. We have great county employees. We have a great county with the people that live here. We sit on the cusp of explosion with business growth. I feel that. ACC is growing leaps and bounds. Thank you, Doctor, for the job you're doing. So it is an exciting time. It's going to be a tough time. We'll have to make some tough decisions, but it is going to be an exciting time to be a member of this board. I'm excited about it, and I look forward to working with every one of you. With that being said, any other business from any of you?
Mr. Chairman, if I could mention the reception at Captain White's at 11.
Thank you. Reception at Captain White at 11, and I left somebody out, but our sheriff is the best in the state.
He's going to have his swearing in today, too.
He's swearing in today, and I'll be there.
His swearing in is at 1 o'clock at Lamb Chapel for all the deputies as well.
Thank you. And that, any other business from the board? Meeting adjourned.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for watching the Alamance County Commissioners Meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building, located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Typically, the first meeting of the month is held at 9 a.m., and the second meeting is held at 7 p.m. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel, beginning at 10 p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching Commissioner meetings online. For technical questions regarding this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of the commissioners' meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information on the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says County Commissioners to visit the commissioners' website, where you can learn about our commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting.